to protect the bad guys, and I'm treated like you know, like a traitor, you know, like I'm committing treason.
We have a perpetual war which gives the incumbent sitting president over there in the Oval Office a 10 to 15 point bounce on all public opinion. He is a wartime president, even though actually we're not at war. there's something really weird here. The truth, fact is fiction, fiction is fact, war is peace, peace is war. What the hell's going on here?
I mean, Mr. Bush is very cleverly manipulated. The fear, the anxiety that 9/11 sprang upon the people of New York and ultimately the entire country. And every time he wants to jack up his ratings, he simply stirs up the fear pot by upgrading the level of impending danger without any specifics, of course. I think it's just, it's a very ugly game that's being played on the Americans.
There's something so similar between our administration and Al-Qaeda in its certainty that God is on its side that is laughable, and that the American people should fall for this line hurts me more than I can tell you.
Norman Mailer wrote the other day that he believed that America had entered a pre-fascist state. What's your view of that?
Well, in a way, and I'm not saying this to be cynical, but I hope he's right, because there are others that are saying we're already in a fascist sort of mode. If you say something often enough, the people will begin to believe it, and that strategy has been applied with, unfortunately, great success by this administration. Weapons of mass destruction, Al-Qaeda, Iraq ties, other evidence being adduced to justify an unprovoked war. And so, yeah, I think we ought to all be worried about fascism.
I think the rest of us should be extremely concerned. We've seen total disregard for the United Nations Charter, and its fundamental concepts. We've seen rejection of international law and the respect for sovereignty of other countries. We've seen a preemptive strike against a sovereign state, which is outrageous in concept and dangerous in consequence, and something we should all worry about. And every country that now is threatened by Mr. Bush, which is his habit, whether it's Iran or North Korea or Syria or Libya or others, it's an outrage that we should stand by and allow these countries to be threatened by a man so dangerous that he's willing to sacrifice American lives and worse, the lives of others, whether they're Iraqis or Afghanis and possibly Syrians and others, in some mad aggression.
Aggression was at the core of the judgment at the Nuremberg trial of the German leadership following World War II. The judges decided that unprovoked aggression was the supreme international war crime, which contained all the evils of other war crimes.
Blair and Bush have found ways of justifying, of course, the wars both against Afghanistan and against Iraq in terms of particular circumstances or the violation of particular requirements. But it seems to me that these wars are indeed acts of aggression as defined at Nuremberg and in previous agreements, and that in a sense, both Bush and Blair are guilty and could stand in the dock, accused of waging aggressive war.
The United Nations was founded so that we would never forget the crimes of great power. Are we now in danger of forgetting? Do we forget the lies that justified the conquest of Iraq and disguised America's plans to dominate all the world? Do we forget that the British government has announced, for the first time, that it's prepared to launch an attack with nuclear weapons, echoing yet again George Bush? And do we accept a distortion of intellect and morality that empties noble words like democracy and liberation of their true meaning, that says it's wrong for a terrorist to kill innocent people, but right for governments to commit the same crimes in our name? The answer is that we need not accept any of this if we recognize that there are now two superpowers. One is the regime in Washington, the other is public opinion, now stirring all over the world, perhaps as never before. Make no mistake, it's an epic struggle. The alternative is not just the conquest of faraway countries, it's the conquest of us, of our minds, our humanity, and our self-respect. If we remain silent, victory over us is assured.